Hey guys, and Angry Joe, if you're watching this, although you're probably not. But you know, my name is David Kwan. I'm just another guy on YouTube who just makes videos here and there about a whole bunch of different things. You should know that I'm a huge Metal Gear fan. Metal Gear Solid, Metal Gear is probably my favorite franchise in all of gaming. And I pretty much played every single Metal Gear game except Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Haven't had the chance to do that. It's not canon, so I don't really consider it, like a must play, something I have to play. But it's on my list of games to play later on. Oh, actually, there's one Metal Gear game that I haven't really fully played, which is Metal Gear Solid Ghost Babel for Game Boy Color. I played like the first an hour or so, but I've never really been able to complete that game. But all other Metal Gear games, including Metal Gear Acids, and Mobile, Metal Gear Solid Touch. Yeah, I played all those. I'm a huge fan of Metal Gear series, so you should know that before I continue. I know you're a new fan, and that's going to be one of the things I touch on in this video as well. But anyway, first off, I think you make really great points, and you sum up your points really well from the very beginning. I'll listen to that first and just give you my thoughts on that. Cool intro music, though.
Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes is a plain old cash grab by Konami that exploits people's excitement for the full release of Metal Gear Solid The Phantom Pain.
Okay, so that's your main point there, you know, that it's a cash grab to exploit people of their excitement. All your statement there, I pretty much agree. I do not disagree with much of that, except maybe the sentiment. So, yes, Ground Zeroes is a cash grab. Just like how Gran Turismo 5 Prologue is a cash grab, just like how, I don't know, freaking many of those other things, you know, as you mentioned, Dead Rising 2 case, I forgot the name of that game, but you know, that's like a cash grab too. DLC, all these kind of things are cash grabs. So no disagreement there. Maybe, you know, you think, Our sentiments are different in that you think this is like a horrible, awful thing, right? Because, as you word it, it exploits the people's excitement for Phantom Pain. Now, exploit, I think, is a very strong word to use in the case of Ground Zeroes, simply because of how this game was marketed from the very beginning. And now, I realize that it's not the consumer's job to follow the marketing. That's too much expectation out of a consumer. But at the same time, you know, it's the producers and the game makers, their job to make it clearer to the consumers what it is they're doing. And you know, maybe this whole thing of Ground Zeroes is a bit confusing. I know a whole bunch of games journalists in IGN and some in GameSpot were confused too. They were like, what's going on with Ground Zeroes? How much is it? Or, you know, why does it exist? There was that kind of confusion there. And for a game company, they should make every effort to make sure that confusion doesn't exist. So I understand, it's pretty frustrating. But they made a lot of, I think Kojima Productions made pretty good effort in marketing this game as what it is. You know, if you looked at all the trailers, if you looked at all the, watch all the interviews or listen to how Kojima has marketed this, Konami has marketed this product, it's been marketed as what it is. You know, they never overhyped it to be more than what it is. They've always said it's a sample of what's to come in Phantom Pain, that it's going to focus one setting, Camp Omega, and that it's not going to, even though Metal Gear Solid V Phantom Pain is an open-world game, Kojima flat out said he doesn't consider Ground Zeroes to be an open-world game, but like a tutorial to go into Phantom Pain. He's been very honest with this. If you look at all the trailers, you know, very honest marketing. So I think exploit is a pretty strong word. Although, yeah, we are being pretty much pulled into it. We're being teased into it, enticed into it. And some people are going to be upset, you know, that this is what it is, and after buying it, some people are going to regret their purchase because of the promise of the trailers and promise of the interviews. This, you know, going against the fact that, you know, this is what Kojima explained. You know, this is what it is at all times. You know, I applaud I know Ground Zeroes is very skimpy on content. It's a very small tease, and it kind of feels off that way. I know after I beat Ground Zeroes, even after playing so many hours of it, I do get the feeling like, oh man, like I wish there was so much more than just this. You know, I get that feeling, but you know, at the same time, it's just this is for the fans. And, you know, considering Phantom Pain, who knows when that's going to be released? It doesn't even have a freaking release date yet. All we know is that it's probably going to come out in 2016, which is 2 years from now. But it might even be delayed to 2017. Well, not delayed, but it might actually be 2017. Which means we're going to be waiting for 3 years for a Metal Gear game. Not only we, but you have to think about Konami as a business. They're going to be waiting for, you know, working on it for 3 years, not making any revenue for that 3 years is their main concern. There has, Kojima Productions has been working on the Fox Engine for God knows how long, and they haven't released a single game that uses this engine. So there is that monetary push. That's why, yes, it is a cash grab. So I totally agree on that, although I don't have as a strong of a negative feeling about it as you do. Is it a dangerous precedent? I don't really think so. I don't think Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes, even if it does extremely well, is a dangerous precedent because of how it was, you know, how it was told, marketed, sold, and it is what it is. It's a pretty freaking fantastic experience, even though it's short, and it's highly replayable. I know you made a later criticism about that replayable comment. I'll get to that. But first, Tank, the first thing I want to get to is the fact that this is your first Metal Gear game. What the fuck? Like, seriously? This is your first game that you played? I don't understand that. You make a living by playing video games. Seriously, like, I don't understand how it is that Ground Zeroes is your first Metal Gear game. Okay, that's fine. This can be your first Metal Gear game, that's fine. But then you have the audacity after that to complain about, like, you know, the game doesn't explain the backstory or who Chico and Paz are or all these characters are, and you don't understand that. Well, I agree. The frustration that you feel, I totally empathize with you in that Kojima doesn't usually make those concessions. You know, if you played Metal Gear Solid 4, it kind of assumes you played Metal Gear Solid 2 and 3. Although it explains so much during cutscenes and whatnot. Ground Zeroes already expects that you play Peace Walker. Yeah, sure. That's frustrating, right? I get that as a person who never played any other Metal Gear games before. That's frustrating. But it's not, you know, at the same time, again, Ground Zeroes does give you some stuff to catch you up on it. There's the backstory. I know it's reading, and gamers don't like reading, maybe, but it's pretty short. It's 11 pages, but each page is like two paragraphs, so it's barely a page. I would say it's 3 pages of text if you put it on a book. 3 pages of text giving you entire backstory of Metal Gear Solid 3, some part of, not even, well, Portable Ops, not really, but Metal Gear Solid 3 and Peace Walker, the entire story is there. There's so much audio logs in this game. There's like an hour's worth of audio log you can listen to, that where characters talk, where Paz kind of explains, where Big Boss and Miller explaining to each other, talk to each other about what's going on. So there is backstory there. You just have to seek it out. I know that kind of is weird. You know, there's very little story in terms of the cutscenes in the game, but that's one of the things that Kojima's pushing for. That's one of his visions with Metal Gear Solid 5, let's cutscenes, because that's been one of the complaints about this franchise. And of course, you missed out on the codec thing. Again, this is the new vision for Ground Zeroes. What's amazing about this franchise is how much change there is with each iteration. When Metal Gear Solid 1 Metal Gear Solid is a dramatic leap from Metal Gear 2, Solid Snake, right? Metal Gear Solid 2 was a dramatic leap from Metal Gear Solid. Metal Gear 3, not as such a dramatic leap per se, but the design choices and all the little changes in between was incredible amount of changes. That's why, you know, so expect changes with this iteration. That codec is no longer existing, that there's no more cardboard box and all these things in Ground Zeroes. Well, that's just how Metal Gear Solid is. Each iteration of the franchise changes the game every time. And that's probably one of the kind of frustrating things about this franchise as a whole, but it's also why Kojima is so revered as a game maker. Because he doesn't, you know, just be like, okay, this works so well, so I'm just gonna carry it over to the next game and improve on it. No, he like totally changes things, right? He adds things, he removes things, he replaces things. Somebody who's an expert at Metal Gear Solid 3 doesn't mean that person is going to be an expert in Metal Gear Solid 4 or 2, because even though the concepts are pretty similar, like I said, each iteration changes things up dramatically. So that's that. You know, why am I so surprised that this is your first Metal Gear game? I know that you are mainly an Xbox user. Right, you don't really. I don't. I think you mentioned that you don't have a PlayStation 3 or whatever. So you know, if you never played Metal Gear Solid 4, I think that's understandable. But you make your living off of playing, you know, making video game reviews and things. Metal Gear Solid 2 and 3 have had HD collection versions. There's a Legacy Editions. I don't know. I feel like there's really no excuse to not have played Metal Gear games as a reviewer. Even if you only own an Xbox, and if you're going into this franchise and know that story is, you know, the franchise as a whole is so important, I don't know, like that's so weird. But I do appreciate that you did research a lot about the Metal Gear franchise. What is different about Ground Zeroes compared to Peace Walker and 4? Quite a lot, amazingly a lot. Like I said, each iteration changes things so much. You and I both agree that Ground Zeroes, as an experience, however short amount of time you play it, is pretty amazing, right? You've said that it's like Game of the Year material when Phantom Pain comes out. Sure, I don't know if I'll go that far, but the experience I had with Ground Zeroes is pretty amazing. I've spent 7 hours with it. I don't know if I'll spend any more of it simply because I feel like I'm spending way too much time on this short amount of content, but there is still desire to play more of it. But I think I'll stop. But I played 7 hours, you played an hour and a half, and that was it for you. Which I think is fine, but I think that misses the point of how replayable Metal Gear Solid is as a franchise. You mentioned, yeah, like, you know, all games you can replay as many times you want. Yeah, sure, but it really depends on, do you want to replay or do you not want to? And for me, I can't speak for anyone else here, but for me, Metal Gear Solid games have always been great to replay. You have no idea how many times I've replayed Metal Gear Solid 1. Maybe, I think it's like over 20 times. You know, maybe is that because I'm an obsessive fan with this franchise? Maybe. But it's also because each time you play, there's different ways to play this game. You know, Ground Zeroes in particular. You can go, you know, you can try to not use any weapons at all and complete the game that way and not get discovered, no kills. You're not using weapons, so well, you can still kill people without using weapons, but yeah, you can do no kill, no alerts, no reflex mode. You can do all kinds of tweaks with this game, so that's where the replayability comes from. And each time and you get different rankings for how you play the game. I don't like the SA, you know, the traditional Japanese ranking system, but I feel like that's been carried over from Peace Walker because that's how Peace Walker did it. Before Peace Walker, Metal Gear Solid games usually had a ranking system that's like code names, you know. You could get a Foxhound rank or Big Boss rank or Fox rank, Chicken rank. Chicken rank is funny, you know, that's like if you eat, no, that's, sorry, not chicken, but pig. Pig ranking is like, if you use up so many rations during your playthrough, you'll get a pig ranking. So there's all kinds of interesting ways to replay the game. And that's kind of what Kojima is saying that you can do with Ground Zeroes, and he's absolutely right. You can. You really can. Now, I wonder, you know, during your playthrough of Ground Zeroes, you said it was like 4 hours, you know, after playing all the missions. I don't know. Did you check out hard mode? Because I think that really changes things. Normal mode and hard mode in Ground Zeroes are ridiculously different. Hard mode is ridiculously hard. And you know, I've watched some Let's Plays of Ground Zeroes, or from people who are not Metal Gear fans, and, you know, I generally don't have this opinion that this game should be played this way, you know? Everyone is free to play their games however they want to play it, you know? But this is also a bad thing about, you know, Metal Gear Solid franchises is the tutorials suck. Ground Zeroes has no really tutorial at all, so that kind of makes sense why people will be playing Ground Zeroes the way they play when they're not, you know, when it's like their first time. I've had a hard time with it too when I first was trying Ground Zeroes, but I played Metal Gear Solid 4 before and Peace Walker before, so I was more, the transition was much easier for me. But I imagine if you've never played a Metal Gear game before, I think that's, I can understand why, you know, playing it would be a little awkward. Like, I was watching this Let's Play of, I think it was DSP Gaming. I think he's, which is weird, because he's played Metal Gear games before. But the way he was playing the game was just like, oh my god, seriously? You know, there's a guy, there's a guard coming to his location because he's been, like, suspicious. So he's behind the wall. You know, Metal Gear Ground Zeroes allows you to put your back against the wall and wait. And when you're like that, when an enemy is near, you can press the, you know, I think he was using a PlayStation 4, but so you can press R1 to grab the guy without being spotted. But instead of that, you know, he wasn't putting his back against the wall, he was just there, and he's like, and then he gets caught, and he would use the reflex mode to shoot the guy down. Mowing a guy down like that, it was just weird. I was like, wait, this is, you didn't really need to play it like that, you know, to not get discovered. So yeah, it's a very difficult game for a new person, to become a new fan of. I think at this point, Kojima's really made pretty much only Metal Gear games, save for a couple. So all his Metal Gear games have been like love letters to fans like me who played every single Metal Gear game there is. And in that sense, Ground Zeroes is still pretty much amazing. It's still a love letter. It's a short love letter, but it gets me super, super excited for Phantom Pain. I bought the digital edition, so I've only paid $20 for it, so maybe that's why I'm not as upset if I spent, I don't know, like $40 or something, which I agree. $20 is an overpriced price for Ground Zeroes, sure. $30 is sure, but, you know, it's I got into it knowing what I was getting, you know. Maybe that's because I, unlike many consumers, I follow the news quite closely with Ground Zeroes because I am such a huge fan of the franchise. And I wanted to check the experience out, because if the experience of Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes sucked, then I'd be extremely worried about Phantom Pain. The experience was great. The only problem here is the length of the experience. You know, well, some of the side missions sucked, you know, and I really don't like how Kojima handled the whole extra ops things, you know, oh, exclusive extra op for three Xbox versions, Xbox consoles, and exclusive extra ops for the PlayStation consoles. Really stupid. I don't know why they did that, and even the extra ops missions themselves aren't even that great. The Deja Vu mission, I finally unlocked it, and I played it a couple, it's like, meh, you know, the side ops are much better. Well, maybe except for the on-rail helicopter sequence. That sucked. Did not like that at all. Well, except for the ending of that segment was pretty damn cool, which you used a lot of footage of. But that's really what I'm saying here, though, you know. In summary, Ground Zero's marketing was honest, at least. It was honest. You know, the pricing was quite expensive. But it was for the fans, and as a fan, you know, I'm pretty satisfied as a fan. I'm left wanting a little bit, but I'm glad this exists, because I really don't think I wanted to wait 2 or 3 more years for Phantom Pain, you know? So this was a good taste of what is to come, and I'm definitely excited. So that's me not, I'm not really defending it, but I'm just saying this is how, like, I see it. As a fan, is it a dangerous precedent? I don't think so, not really. Gran Turismo 5 Prologue sold bucket loads, and you know, you don't really see companies making you know, charging for just chopping their games up and like that. You don't really see that as a trend happening, even after Gran Turismo 5 Prologue. I don't see that happening even after Ground Zero selling bucket loads. I do not think this is a dangerous precedent because of how it was done. If it was done like... Okay, so a dangerous precedent to me is kind of like what happened with Prince of Persia in back in 2008, the reboot. You know, the true ending to that game was sold separately as DLC. That was a dangerous precedent. Because that's what started happening. That was ridiculous, right? This, and the marketing was totally not honest. You know, when Prince of Persia was released, was announced, all throughout its release, that was never mentioned. This whole thing about true ending, DLC, whatever, never mentioned. Only mentioned after like a week of the release, which you can't make a true ending in development time in a week. That's ridiculous. So that's a dangerous precedent. Ground Zeroes is not a dangerous precedent. It's just what it is. Honest marketing for the fans. If you're getting into it and this is your first Metal Gear game, play some other Metal Gear games, you know, before going into this one. Get the HD collection and play that, you know, or get some emulators and play Metal Gear 1 and Metal Gear 2. I know the controls are a bit outdated. And each Metal Gear game has different controls and different difficulties. But yeah, like, seriously, this can't be your first Metal Gear game as a video game reviewer. Just can't be. You gotta change that. That's my final saying. You gotta change that. Whatever you said about Ground Zeroes are valid in a lot of ways. This is my response to it. But at the end of the day, you gotta play the other Metal Gear Solid games. At least 3. I think you'll really like 3. Don't buy Snake Eater, the original, buy Subsistence. Snake Eater has the fixed camera, so you're going to hate that. Most people hated that. But Subsistence gives you an option of fixed camera and 3D camera. Anyway, Metal Gear Solid 3, no, don't even worry about Subsistence or Snake Eater. Actually, get the HD collection, freaking A, get HD collection, play Peace Walker. If you're excited for Phantom Pain, you need to play Peace Walker, because Metal Gear Solid 5 assumes that you played Peace Walker. It doesn't explain who Chico is, who Miller is, why Big Boss is there, what Mother Base is. It doesn't explain any of that. All that is explained in Peace Walker. So seriously, play MGS3, Peace Walker, then play Ground Zeroes again. Just for the sake of it, because I think you'll get more enrichment out of that after you play. And listen to all the audio tapes. Seriously, that's pretty... I would, as a fan, the audio dialogues, Podge's diary, the mission briefings, that made me feel justified in paying $20 for this thing, because it was amazing. Just the amount of subtle details that are in those audio tapes. It's weird, right? To have a game where the most amazing thing was not the gameplay itself, but the audio tapes. That's a weird thing. That's one of the weird things about this franchise is it's not always the gameplay experience that pulls you into this franchise. But like you said, like Kodak Conversations, those are some of those moments in Kodak Conversations. Just listening to the game makes this game amazing. Some of those moments, you know, a lot of the other games like Call of Duty, the most epic moments are like, yeah, like I shot that thing down, or like I did this in the game. With Metal Gear Solid, some of those epic moments are really like out of the box or more out of the game. You know, when you first play Psycho Mantis, the boss fight itself isn't particularly that great. You know, what is great is the fourth wall breaking concept of, oh, I can't use my controller to beat this boss. Like, that is what makes Metal Gear great. You know, and that's the most epic moment about Psycho Mantis boss fight. And there's things like that, and there's moments like that in all Metal Gear games, even Acid. I can't remember what some of those moments are, but even spin-offs of Metal Gear games have this kind of, you know, out of the box, like, whoa, this is a Metal Gear game moment. And that's why this franchise is loved so much, and that's why Metal Gear Ground Zeroes can't be the only Metal Gear game you played in 2014. That makes no sense. Well, it makes sense if you're just an average gamer. But you're not an average gamer. You're a gamer who makes video reviews of games for a living. That changes everything. You have to play Metal Gear. That's my final thing, and I'll end with that. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.